When I got the first one, I was literally seconds away from stepping onto the plane when a call from unknown blared from my cell phone. It was a ringtone I hadn't heard before, one I was pretty sure hadn't come with the phone. Normally, I wouldn't have stopped to answer it, but I was expecting a call about a job I had interviewed for the previous week. I took a deep breath and accepted the call. "Hello? Do not get on the plane." A woman's voice, garbled and strange, as if her vocal cords had been shredded and she was trying desperately to choke out speech. Despite the unnerving, fractured quality of her voice, her tone was intent and eerily calm. Then the call ended. I froze. I had always had a slight phobia of air travel. Something about this call just... There was no way I was about to get on a 7-hour flight now. I turned around and headed towards the food court. I'd just get another flight later, in the afternoon, I figured. I watched from the airport, Starbucks, 3 hours later, as every TV in the terminal lit up with the crash footage of the plane I should have been on. No survivors, not a single one. I tried to trace the call, so did the police, but there was nothing to trace. There was no evidence my phone had ever received a call around that time. They analyzed phone records, incoming and outgoing communication to my phone. Nothing. I wasn't making it up. I couldn't have been. That wasn't the only call. Throughout the years, they were few and far between, but always right. And I always listened. Do not go on that blind date tonight. 5 months later, my would-be date was convicted of killing 4 women, all with my hair color and build. Found them in a shallow grave about 250 feet from the diner he offered to take me to. Do not drive to the concert tonight. An 18-wheeler lost control and plowed into a line of cars. Every driver crushed, every driver killed in the stretch of the freeway I would have been driving down. No matter if I got a new phone, if I moved across the country, the calls would still come. I could almost feel the presence of whatever it was, whatever it is, watching over me. I imagined being at the bottom of the freezing ocean, still strapped into the coach section plane seat, or being in that mass grave across from the diner, watching an 18-wheeler skidding towards my car, knowing death was imminent. And I'd get this tightness in my chest. I think about how thin that line was, how close I'd gotten. If I hadn't had a job interview I was waiting to hear back from, I'd have never listened to that first call, and that would be it for me. It always felt like something was coming for me, but there was always this fractured, warped voice with these calls that never seemed to exist after I heard them. Self-destructing warning signs. rotting away before my eyes, and I was alive. I had a bad feeling about this cruise. I had planned it as a girls' weekend out with some of my old friends from college, and was looking forward to a week in the tropics in the dead of winter. But part of me could almost sense that call was coming. Maybe I had watched Titanic one too many times, but there was a little nagging fear from the start. I hoped it would be fine, but I knew that if something was going to happen, I'd get that call. I'd know. Now a week before I'm set to go on the cruise, after stepping into my apartment, after returning from dinner with a friend, I noticed my cell phone has a message from unknown. They've never had to leave a message before. Haven't checked it at all that night. Damn it. And I really wanted to go on that cruise too. Oh well, it's not worth whatever horrific fate awaited me in that cold, dark ocean. I clicked play and felt my stomach drop as I listened to the voice, sounding horrifically distorted, as if it emanates from a throat slashed to ribbons, crackling with more urgency than ever before. I looked around my apartment as the voice on the phone repeats the same phrase over and over again. Do not go home tonight. Do not go home tonight after dinner. Do not come home tonight after dinner. Do not come home after dinner tonight. Thank you for listening, and I know I've been gone for some time, but I really appreciate your support, and I can't wait to make more content now that I'm more available, that school's out. And don't forget, I'll see you.